Good morning, class. Today we're actually going to be discussing the 7th class for business, grade 11. And our topic today is going to be jobs and careers, all right? So, first of all, a job or an occupation is work that people engage in to earn pay. This means you actually do the work in order to actually get paid, whether it will be paid by benefits or it will just be money or any sort of payment. Now, a career, on the other hand, is basically a work history that a person has or maybe is trying to pursue. So, a career is a work history of one or more jobs in the same or related field. This means the jobs can be, they're all in the same field, but let's say sales, marketing, they're in the same field. Or related fields, like, you know, you can be a manager of a company and you actually need to, in order to pursue that career, you need experience in accounting, sales, marketing, and all of that, which is basically related fields. Now, pursuing a career requires career planning, clearly, because in order to actually achieve something in life, you actually need to plan for it. Now, career planning consists of assessing your potential, analyzing your options, and preparing for the future. Because unless you know what exactly you're capable of, and you actually consider the options that are going to be in front of you, you need to be to do all of that in order to prepare for the future. All right, so we have a couple of things here. We have interests and values. So what are interests? Basically, interests are your favorite activities. I'm interested in football myself, so I like to do the activity of watching it or even playing it, okay? They can actually lead to a career that you would enjoy. A lot of people that I have as friends have actually pursued a career in playing football and such. Now, on the other hand, we have values. Values are things that you basically believe in and you live by. So, it's just everything that you believe in to be important. So, let's say I value my family, so my family always comes first. Let's say in a situation where my family or friends are actually asking me to go out at the same time, we would be able to do that. Okay. So, where can you basically find a job? If you just think normally, you can either find it in newspapers, right? We'll see the advertisements in newspaper. We have sites like Wozoof and LinkedIn, if you know what I mean. And you can actually go to the company and actually ask if they have a vacancy or not. Or you can look on the internet, there are multiple sources. Even your social media right now, so like Facebook or so, we see companies advertising that they need employees to work for them. Now, last but not least, I would just like to ask, like, what exactly do you think a company looks for whenever you're actually trying to, whenever they're trying to recruit you? Right? What exactly are they looking for you, like in you, that they're trying to see in order to actually accept you? So, a lot of the times they're looking for your skills, whether it be communication skills, negotiation skills, and all of that, like learning, basically. Education, because clearly in your resume, you're gonna have to put your education, whether it be school, or college, university, or all of that history. Your age, clearly, like, let me give you an example. Banks will not accept employees as a starter job, like, let's say, a teller at the bank. They will not accept him if he's over 28, all right? So, commitment, and this means not just being committed to the work, it means every literal part of it, which means you go to your work on time. You basically show up to the interview on time. You do your work on the schedule. And basically, the way you present yourself, your qualifications and your experience overall.